One of the topics, or drivers in this case, that fans in the NASCAR world are currently buzzing about is Haley Deegan, and I'm about to explain why next. What is up? Welcome to episode 3 of Hot Take, and NASCAR Hot Take, that is. And I just wanted to talk about this topic because this is something that I had just recently figured out in the middle while I was making a vlog, which had just come out, about a day or two ago. But I'm gonna go ahead and get into it. It's Haley Deegan. And just recently on Saturday, she made her Gander RV and Outdoor Truck Series debut for DGR Crossley Racing. I can't even speak today. It's a Monday, October 19th, 2020, and I'm gonna do an episode on this day, a little bit later on. But for right now, I'm talking about Haley Deegan because, like I said, she made her debut, and in her first race, she finished 16th, which that is the highest finishing position for a female making her debut in the truck series. That's just in her debut, remember that. And the reason why I say that is because that's very impressive, to say the least. I mean, it's definitely not the highest finishing position for a female, because Jennifer Jo Cobb holds that accomplishment still, that dates all the way back to Daytona in 2011. But still, that was Daytona, where basically anybody can do really well. Not to discredit Jennifer Jo Cobb, which that's still, even if it was at a short track or wherever, that is still a pretty impressive accomplishment for a female. But for the highest finishing position for a female in her debut, I say Haley Deegan takes the cake, because she actually drove a very flawless race. She stayed out of trouble. She made maybe a mistake or two by just not gassing it all the way, because she felt like that she ran out of fuel on probably, I think it was her last pit stop of the race. It was a live pit stop, by the way, which she had never really done before up until Saturday. And in the middle of the race, literally just minutes after she started her first race in the trucks, it was announced that she would be going full time in the Cup Series in 2021. And honestly, there are some fans that I looked at and that I saw on the Discord server, some of the Discord servers that I'm in, they were either happy or really concerned or just really had mixed feelings. And I'm gonna say this, just my personal opinion, is that I'm kind of also in that mixed feelings category. Yes, I'm like very happy that that Haley Deegan is going to get this opportunity to run a full schedule in the truck series. However, I have mixed feelings, because number one, she's going to be running this full schedule, and a lot of the racetracks are either, some of the racetracks are, it's a mix of mile and a halfs, 1 mile racetracks, some short tracks, some, a couple super speedways, and some 2 mile racetracks. and a lot, some of those tracks she has never really raced on before. And also to add on to that, ARCA, the competition in ARCA is very, very laid back. So that third place finish in the point standings for her, yes, that is super impressive. But, you know, she really, I mean, just like as far as competition wise, it was very laid back, and she kind of was on cruise control. No, and again, I'm not trying to discredit Haley Deegan for that third place finish in the points, which is still really, really impressive, to say the least. But the difference between competition in ARCA and in trucks definitely takes the cake, because they are way more competitive there, and they're more aggressive and they tend to go for more wins and more championships if you're in that position. Whereas for ARCA, it's kind of similar, but the racing, as I said, is more laid back and you're basically handed over either a win or a championship. Just ask Ty Gibbs, who got the most wins this year. 6 wins and led more laps than anybody else. And he only made 16 starts and still finished in the top 5 in the points. That goes to show you that competition in ARCA is not good at all. You could start half the season and wound up 5th or top 5 in the point standings. Heck, even if you won all 10 races that you entered, you could be champion. I don't know. I mean, I know I'm probably blowing that out of proportion, but then, you know, it's kind of screwed up of how the ARCA series is now, and it's really the competition there is just fading. It's getting laid back. As far as Haley Deegan's case, yes, she may have learned a lot, but just the ARCA series is definitely not competitive, not as competitive as the truck series is. Whereas trucks, you know, they're just very competitive a lot, and they're very aggressive, and I think Haley Deegan will, I think, thrive a little bit more in that kind of environment, because she's had to go through that in the K&N the K&N series over in the West, where, you know, a vast majority of the schedule is short tracks and also a road course or two. I think it was just one road course with Sonoma. But I think in that kind of environment, I think she'll start to learn a little bit more. And then from there, she can start taking the puzzle pieces that she's been able to gather up throughout the season, apply them, and then get really competitive and racy. I think she can do it. Because, like, in today's day and age, there's a lot of pressure on women to perform get behind the wheel of top-tier equipment, like DGR Crossley, for instance. Not saying that they're top-tier equipment, like top-tier, but they're right there. And, you know, for Danica, I mean, like, she had that same pressure, but obviously she didn't live up to those expectations, you know, as well as a lot of people thought that she could have, but unfortunately it just wasn't the case. As far as Haley Deegan goes, she's really done a very good job. I mean, the thing is, she doesn't have to think about the pressure. She knows and is aware that she has that pressure to go out there, compete, win races, especially because of the fact that she's a female. And her dad, Brian, and I think some other people are telling her, you know, just don't think about that pressure. Just go out, have fun, go win races. You know, just go out there and race. That's it. That's all you have to think about. Don't think about the pressure. Just go out there and race. And Haley Deegan in that stance is doing a very good job, especially on Saturday, because she did very, very nice, very flawless on the track. I think she'll do good in trucks. It's just the mixed feelings of, like, how is she going to do in these first few races with the competition that is in the truck series, and as well as the different kind of setups. You know, because the setup in a truck is a lot different than an ARCA, because the truck, I think, is a little bit more high downforce and a little less horsepower, just a tad less horsepower. Or I think it's right around where a cup car is, I don't know. But still, either way, regardless of the fact of the setups, competition, it's just, how is Haley Deegan going to do in these first few races for me? That's my only concern, is how is she going to do in these first few races? And if she does great, then I think she'll probably do okay. But we'll just have to wait and see. But anyways, that's going to do it for episode 3 of Hot Take. I want to thank you guys a lot for watching. If you guys like the video, go ahead and give it a like. If you have not considered subscribing yet, recommend you do so in order to keep up with some fine content coming out in the near future. And that about does it for me. I'll see you in the next one.